So kids, how are you? I'm back for you. I'm your SS teacher. It's for the standard 4th subject SS English medium class. Okay, we are on the page number 34 and 35. Okay, now we are on the chapter number 5, the coastal plains and the islands. Okay, the page number 34 and 35. There is the chapter 5, the coastal plains and the islands. Okay, the rest of the topics is the climate. Okay, we can see these features of the coastal area. Okay, where it is lies, and it is the 7000 kilometer stretch. Okay, so it's a spread to west side to south side and the east side to south side. So now we are on the climate of this area. Okay, in which area? The coastal plains and the islands area. The climate is the coastal plains area of the peninsula of India. Okay, coastal area, which is the downside, the southern portion of our country. Okay, so stretch from the west to south. Okay, stretch from the east to south. So both sides are peninsula. Peninsula means what? Peninsula means three side water and the one side land. It is called peninsula India. Okay, the downside, the down portion of our country is a peninsula. So the coastal plains of the peninsula area, okay, we have a western side, there is the Arabian Sea, eastern side there is a Bay of Bengal, the downside the Indian Ocean, and the north side there is a land of the southern portion of our country, India's. Okay, so it's a peninsula area, have a tropical humid climate. Okay, of this area, okay, the coastal plains of islands area, this area there is a humid climate. Okay, there is a humid climate. Humid climate means what? Humid climate. Okay, it is influenced by the sea. Okay, it's a very near to sea, it's a border of the sea. Okay, both side, the west side and the east side, both side nearer to sea. So there is influenced by the sea and experience a moderate climate. Okay, there is a moderate climate. They have a moderate climate because they are very near to sea. Okay, so it's a experience of moderate climate. Moderate means what? Moderate means neither too hot nor too cold. Okay, it's a climate of this area, the coastal lines area. There is a not so hot in summer and not so cold in winter. So it's a moderate climate there. So because of that, it's a experience of moderate climate, neither so hot in summer and not too very cold in winter. Okay, this, the people of this areas, they have experience not so hot in summer and not so cold in a winter season. Okay, so there is a moderate climate. Okay, and monsoon of this area, the south side, the down side, southwest sides. Okay, southwest side, there is a monsoon winds, because it is monsoon depends on the winds. Okay, monsoon totally depend on the winds of the clouds. So it's a southwest monsoon brings a heavy rainfall to western coastal area. Okay, the southwest monsoon. Okay, southwest monsoon brings a heavy rainfall because of the winds direction this side. So the southern west winds comes there, and because of the heavy rain of this coastal area. So this southwest monsoon brings a heavy rainfall to the western coastal from June to September. It's a start from June to September. Okay, it's a start in June month and in September month. okay? So it's a heavy rainfall because of the southwest winds, okay? Southwest monsoons. So there is a eastern, the eastern coastal gets the rainfall. There is eastern side, the eastern side also there is a rainfall during gets rainfall during the October and November, okay? In 2 months, October and November, because of the retreating southwest monsoon. Okay, it's a retreating of the southwest monsoon winds. So because of the aid and there is a rainfall during the October and November, okay, because of the retreating southwest monsoon, southwest wind, okay. And from December to January, okay, they have a two times experience of rainfall, two times experience of monsoon, okay. The first is the because of the retreating of southwest winds monsoon, then they get a rainfall during the October and November, okay. And the December month, there is a monsoon again, the December from January due to the northeast winds, okay. There is a two sides of winds come there, and the first is the during the October and November because of the retreating southwest monsoon, and the it's a from December to January due to the northeast winds. Okay, it's a northeast winds because of the they have a two times of experience of monsoon. Okay, now there is a climate axis in island is a moderate, known as a maritime climate. Okay, it's a very maritime climate. Why it is maritime climate? Okay, we can say it's a moderate, the same name of the maritime climate. Okay, maritime climate means why it is maritime climate? Maritime means the it's a good time for it there. So climate axis islands moderate, known as a maritime climate. Climate because in a summer there is not so hot in this area, and in a winter there is not so cold. So there is they have a moderate experience. Okay, they have a moderate climate. So it's a maritime climate. Okay, we can say maritime climate also. It's a moderate climate. Okay, so in this area mostly have a moderate climate, neither too hot in summer nor too cold in a winter. So and monsoon, okay, the eastern side, western side, they have a only one time from June to September there is a monsoon, and eastern side there is a two times experience. So they have a November to October and November and December to January, okay, because of the winds direction of that. Now we are on the people of this season, okay. The climate already completed. So people of this season, okay, people of this season being a very fertile and pleasant climate, okay, very fertile because there is a nearer to sea, nearer to rivers, nearer to deltas, nearer to lagoons. So because of that, being a very fertile and pleasant climate. Okay, very fertile land because of the water. Okay, it's a support a very large population. This area support a very large population. Mostly people lives nearer to sea, nearer to river, nearer to lagoons, nearer to deltas. So it's a very fertile area. So eastern sides mostly are farmers. Eastern side, eastern coastal area, plain area, the eastern coastal area, there is a mostly a farmers because of the very fertile land there. So and because of the rainfall, because of the suitable rainfall there, there is a eastern side of mostly a farmers, and it encloses a fertile delta. Okay, it is nearer to deltas area. Okay, it's a mostly a farmers there. They are doing farmery. Okay, agriculture. It's a enclosure of fertile delta. Okay, because of the deltas, because of the rivers, because of the available to water, because of the suitable of climate, and there is a pleasant climate also. So the people mostly the farmers. Okay, now then western side are mainly a fisherman. In a western side, okay, western side there is a mainly a fisherman. Known as their skill, okay, they have a skill to fishing. Okay, so mostly the western side is a fisherman and the eastern side mostly a farmers. Okay, and they have a skill to make a handicraft using cord and sail. Okay, they make ornaments. Okay, ornaments, bracelet, and many things to use using a cord and sails, etc. Okay, they use the coastal things. Okay, so they are doing many handicraft and cord and sails using a cord and sails. Islands of this, okay, island also important. Okay, people of these islands, okay, western side mostly fishermen. Okay, they have a skill to fishing, and the eastern side there is a farmers. Mostly they are doing agriculture because there is a suitable climate, available to water. Okay, and the mostly deltas there. So islands, now we are on the islands. Okay, islands of the Lakshadweep, we can say Lakshadweep, which is lies in a Arabian Sea, and the Andaman Nicobar, which is lie in a Bay of Bengal. Okay, it's a group of islands. We already learned in a previous chapter, previous lecture also. So it's the islands of Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar are mostly inhabited by tribal. Okay, they have a there is a mostly tribal people lives there, which is the Bhils, Gonds. Okay, so they have tribal people. They have sufficient things they can use for their daily routine. Okay, so mostly they are doing farming, fishing. Okay, and farming, fishing, and they use the mostly forestry thing. So it's because of that mostly in these islands, Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar islands, mostly are inhabited by tribals. Mostly a tribal people lives there. Okay, then we are on the major part of the western and the eastern coastal plain. Okay, it is the major parts where there is a major part of the western and eastern coastal both side there. So there is a port. What is the port? Okay, port are the cities. Okay, port are the cities with a harbor where the ships are uncaught. Okay, where is a port are the cities with the harbors where the ships are uncaught. Okay, so because of this there is a major ports like in a western coastal line. Okay, the western coastal plain, there is a Kochi, Mangalore, Calicut, Marmangao, Mumbai, and Kandla. Okay, and Kandla are a major part of major port on the western side. Here is the main. There is a Kochi, Mangalore, Calicut, Marmangao, Mumbai, and Kandla are the major ports on the western coast. Okay, and the eastern side, the eastern coastline side, there is a Haldia, Paradip, Visakhapatnam, Chennai, and Tuticorin are the major ports on the eastern coast. Okay, listen, we repeat again. बैंगलोर, कालीकट, मरमंगा, मुंबई एंड कंडला आर द मेजर पार्ट ऑफ वेस्टर्न कोस्ट एंड द हल्दिया, पैरादीप, विशाखापट्टनम, चेन्नई एंड ट्यूटिकोरिन आर द मेजर पार्ट ऑन द ईस्टर्न कोस्ट. ओके, नाउ वी आर इन मुंबई. मुंबई इज द बिगेस्ट पोर्ट इन इंडिया विच इज located in a this western coastal line. Okay, the Mumbai is the biggest port of our country India. Okay, and Visakhapatnam and Kochi have a ship building yard. Okay, there is ship building yard, means there is a mega ship. Okay, with the biggest ship also. So Visakhapatnam and the Kochi have a ship building yards. Okay, now then we are on the importance of the coastal plains and islands. Okay, why it is important? Okay, what's the importance of this coastal plains and this islands? Okay, we have a both side, the western coastal plain and the eastern coastal plain, both side the coastal lines also, and we have islands also. Okay, in Arabian Sea there is a Lakshadweep, and this side the Bay of Bengal there is a Andaman and Nicobar, the group of islands also. So why it is important? Why it is important for us? Okay, so there is a first topic is deltas. Okay, the eastern coastal plain side there is a many deltas. Okay, there is a Sundarbans delta also. Okay, it's the biggest delta of the world. So because of the deltas, the land make a very fertile. Okay, the pleasant climate also there. So it's a suitable for agriculture. Okay, the people of this eastern side mostly doing a farming. Okay, and fishing also major occupation of the western side. There is a fishing is a major occupation of these people. Okay, because of the fishing, they export fish to other countries. Okay, it's a very useful to trade and business also. So it's the export. They western coastal lines, mostly people, their main occupation of fishing. They export the fish to other countries. Okay, so it's a very good for our country. Okay, and the third point, beaches are very important. Okay, we have a very long beaches area, means the very longest coastal area. Okay, we have a 7000 kilometer long coastal area. So beaches are also important. Okay, the mostly tourists attract them and they go there and they enjoy their life. Okay, beaches are very important for them. The Sundarbans, it's a home of Bengal tigers. Okay, the Sundarbans is one of the deltas. Okay, and it is the biggest deltas of the world, and it is because of the deltas there is a river. There is a water three side. So there is a, because of the water there is a dense forest. There is a very deciduous dense forest there. So because of the forest, the wild animals also live there. Because of that, Sundarbans is the home of Bengal tigers. Okay, there is a tigers. We found the tigers there. There are many tigers there. So because of that, it is the home of the Bengal tigers. Okay. Now the Kutch, which lies in Gujarat. Okay, it's a famous for flamingos and the wild races. Okay, it's a very famous Kutch. Okay, the run of Kutch. Okay, it's a desert. So it is in Gujarat. It is very famous for flamingos and the wild races also. Okay, and now the seaports. The seaports help the development of trade with other countries. Okay, because of the seaports, we have many seaports. Just we see here. Okay, we have Kochi, Mangalore, Calicut, Marmanga, Mumbai, and Kandla. It is a major port in a western coast side. The Haldia, Paradip, Visakhapatnam, Chennai, and Tuticorin are the major port on the eastern coast. So this seaport is help to development of trade with other countries. Okay, it's a help to trade by sea route, by sea road. Okay, it's a, because of the sea port helps the develop of trade with other countries. Okay, because of this development, okay, we have it's a biggest big importance for our country. Now the present climate. Okay, there is the sea area, nearer to sea area, the coastal area. It's a very pleasant climate. Okay, not so hot in the summer, not so cold in the winter. So it's a pleasant climate there, and a good amount of rainfall. And there is a good amount of rainfall because of the wind direction. Okay, so there is a support a large population. This area, it's a support a very large population. Mostly many people live there. Okay, because of the pleasant climate and the good amount of rainfall. Okay, now our chapter number 5 is over. Thank you.